This is the story of two American swimmers who competed at the Los Angeles Olympic Games. One is 25-year-old Rowdy Gaines, world record holder in the 100-meter freestyle. Gaines is considered by most too old and past his prime. The other is 20-year-old John Moffet, world record holder in the 100-meter breaststroke, who has an opportunity to win 3 gold medals. Since childhood, both Gaines and Moffet had dreams of hearing the Star Spangled Banner played in their honor at the Olympics. Within 48 hours, both of them would have the opportunity to fulfill their dreams. At 10 o'clock on the morning of July 29, 1984, John Moffet prepared for the 7th heat of the 100-meter breaststroke. 1 month earlier, he set the world record in this event at the Olympic trials, defeating his longtime rival, Steve Lundquist. John Moffet became the favorite to win the gold medal. Moffet swam a magnificent qualifying heat, breaking the Olympic record to become the fastest qualifier. But during the race, he severely tore a leg muscle.
It's just totally indescribable. I can still bring back the feeling of what, it's just complete panic. I just remember walking away from the pool and the crowd cheering, and they just said I broke the Olympic record, and it just really wasn't the same because I just felt like that was it.
6 hours later, John Moffet was in the competitor's tent awaiting the call for the final. The preceding hours were the most tragic of his life.
I couldn't kick breaststroke at all, and I told the coaches I wasn't going to swim. They said, well, we can go to the last resort, and that is to put some local anesthetic into the muscle. So I got the injection. I got my leg wrapped with adhesive tape just as tightly as possible and tried to warm up.
Steve Lundquist, former world record holder, and the man John Moffet defeated in the trials, now becomes the United States' main hope.
Steve and I were roommates, and the only thing that I ever said to Steve was my hopes were really dwindling, and I just told him to win it for the U.S. because I really didn't think that I could do it because it just was too sore. I could barely walk.
The 8 finalists line up. The pool is 50 meters long. They will swim up and back once. All 8 men hit the water simultaneously. After a few strokes, Steve Lundquist inches ahead. Lundquist, second from the top, is the clear leader at 25 meters. Moffet, in lane 4, is having trouble with his kick. Lundquist is swimming at a world record pace. Until Moffet took the record away from him in the Olympic trials, Lundquist had broken the mark 4 times in 2 years. Lundquist makes the turn first, followed by Victor Davis of Canada in lane 7. It is now a 2-man race. Lundquist, second from the top. Davis, second from the bottom. Moffet, in lane 4, in the middle, knows it is all over.
I couldn't kick at all. It was just really tough. I wanted to at least somehow get a medal. I saw Steve, and I knew that there was really no chance to catch him because he was so far ahead.
With 20 meters left, Lundquist, second from the top, leads. Victor Davis of Canada, second from the bottom, trails by 3 feet. Incredibly, John Moffet has moved into 5th place. Steve Lundquist wins and sets a world record. Victor Davis, Canada, second. Peter Evans, Australia, third. Adrian Morehouse, Great Britain, fourth. John Moffet, United States, fifth.
You know, I turned around hoping to at least have medal because I didn't know, and then saw I got fifth. I just remember Steve coming up, and I don't remember anything he said, but it was comforting, and I was glad that he won it for the United States at least.
Lundquist's victory earns him an opportunity for a second gold medal. He will swim the breaststroke on the 4x100 medley relay team. Moffet's injury is so severe, he must withdraw from the 200-meter breaststroke. Though John Moffet is unable to swim, his story here at the Los Angeles Olympic Pool is not yet over.